With another Sport Universe podcast, where the sports are our universe. I'm Brian, and I'm joined today by my friend Evan. This isn't going to be one of those usual, very serious, knowledgeable conversations that I have with my other co-hosts. This is going to be more of a comical podcast. Depends how funny Evan's trying to be today. So if you want it to be a more knowledgeable conversation, you might want to click off of this podcast. You have something to say, Evan?
I don't like the podcast regardless.
Oh, okay. So this is going to be, it's not going to be like, I don't know how to explain it, but I'm going to try and hold a conversation. Okay, hold on. So if you don't know who Evan is a kid who I would say doesn't know a lot about sports or what's going on. I think maybe he likes to stay in the know about sports, but probably doesn't know a lot about what's going on. So what I'm going to try to do today is kind of hold a conversation like a regular podcast would be and see how much BSing he has to come up with to make it an actual conversation. So, Evan, if you want to introduce yourself a little bit before we get started.
Sure. So, I just graduated college last month. Very exciting. I've known Brian for a long time. We worked together at camp. And, like you said, I don't know that much about sports. But, you know, I know, I guess, some stuff, and we'll see. I guess this will determine what I know. And hopefully I don't sound too foolish, and Brian doesn't make a fool of me.
My plan is to make a fool of him. I mean, I started these podcasts, like, a couple weeks ago, and obviously Evan was jealous, and I was kind of surprised when he said he wanted to do a podcast. Obviously he was jealous of me doing a podcast.
Not exactly.
Didn't you do someone's podcast at your school at one point? Or you... Were you not? Am I wrong?
Wait. You gotta say it again, I didn't hear.
Oh my god. We're on FaceTime right now, so it might be cut in and out. But I said, didn't you do someone's podcast at school once? Like, didn't you tell me that? Like, one of your friends?
Oh, my friend has a radio show, but guests aren't allowed to talk on the radio show.
Oh, Jesus
podcast?
That's probably what I'm talking about.
Yeah, probably. Like, I would go to his show every weekend. I'd sit there while he did his show.
It's so sweet.
So I've learned some of the
So if Evan has a good radio voice, that's why.
Exactly. I've learned some of the on-air, like, practices.
Yeah. Podcasts are better.
We'll see.
Okay. So first what I'm going to do is I kind of structured a little quiz for Evan that I'm going to go through to get a basis of how much knowledge he actually knows about sports. Some of them are going to be really easy questions, and we'll see if he knows them. And then I'm going to try and hold a conversation with him. Okay. You ready?
Let's try it out.
Okay, here we go. How many bases are there on a baseball diamond?
4.
Wow. That was the easiest one there. So you want to
get
started?
Is that the end?
Is that the end?
Yeah.
No, it's not the end.
Okay.
Trying to figure out what order to do this. Okay. Can you name 5 major sports franchises in New York?
From any sport?
Yeah.
Rangers, Knicks.
Oh, I was not expecting you to know any hockey teams.
Brian, please. Rangers, Knicks, Yankees, Giants, Jets.
Jesus Christ. I didn't know he knew that much. Okay.
Or.
So I'm not going to ask you that one because you obviously know that. Now I gotta think of harder ones.
I'm kind of offended that you think too hard.
I didn't think you knew. Okay, whatever. Which of those teams would you say you know about the most?
Not the Rangers. Not the Jets. The most, like the players, you mean?
Yeah.
I guess the Yankees.
Okay, can you name 7 current Yankees?
That is a tough question.
That's why I'm asking.
Okay. Let's think. 7 current Yankees. Robinson Cano is not there anymore, right?
Yeah, what team is he on?
I could not tell you.
The Mets.
7 current Yankees.
Or 5 current Yankees. 3. Can you name 1?
Can I name one current Yankee? Of course. Aaron Judge.
Okay. Can you name another one?
That good?
Yeah, that's one. Can you name another one?
Was that good?
Yes. Can you name another one?
Okay. Sorry.
It cut out.
Aaron Judge. What's this? Oh my god. Okay, well, I don't want to say it in case I'm like really wrong.
Just say it.
Ishiro?
Are you thinking of Ishiro Takahashi or something?
Yeah.
I don't think he's not in the Yankees anymore. But he was an older player, so I'm surprised you knew that.
Was he on the Yankees?
I think so. If you can't think of another one, I'll just go on.
That's a tough one, yeah. I'll come back to it.
Alright. You don't have to come back to it.
Yeah, probably won't.
What?
I probably won't.
Wow. Okay.
I mean, I'll think, but no. Promises.
No? You already said it. Okay.
Wait. Hold on. Anderson.
No.
No, okay.
Okay. Is that it?
Yes.
Okay. Now I'm gonna list some first names of notable sports players, and then I wanna see if Evan can guess their last name. Or knows their last name. Okay, we'll start off easy. LeBron.
Wouldn't it be easier to do a last name? And then I give you the first name?
Well, it's not supposed to be super easy for you.
I guess so, but like, people can have the same first names. Alright.
It's sports players, you want to know them. LeBron.
Who?
LeBron.
James.
Kevin.
Durant.
Steph.
Curry.
Kawhi.
Leonard.
Michael. He's an older player.
What?
He doesn't play anymore.
Basketball?
Yeah.
Jordan.
Tom. This is football.
I feel basketball. Oh, Brady.
Damn it. Eli.
Manning.
Saquon.
Bark.
Alright. Jeez, you know much more. Okay,
that
I'm just
last
gonna.
Was what? Like a deep ball.
Alright, I'm just gonna go to my next idea, which is just trying to hold a conversation with you because you know much more. Because
I'm far too smart for this.
Yeah.
Except for the Yankee.
I mean, you still got some. Okay. So we're going to talk about the NBA Finals. If you want this serious conversation about the NBA Finals, I'm recording a podcast with the usual co-host soon.
Stay tuned for this one, for the serious pod, the serious conversation.
Okay. All right. So, as you know, the in the NBA Finals, it's who versus who?
It is the Toronto Raptors versus the GSW.
What does that stand for?
That was Golden State Warriors.
Wow, I mean, he already has short names for them. Okay,
of course.
So, do you know what the series is at right now?
I believe it's at 3-1 Raptors.
Yeah, it is.
And there was a game Friday?
What's today? Saturday? Today's Saturday.
It's Sunday.
Yeah, there was a game Friday. There was. You're right.
Okay. Yeah.
And...
I do not know when the next game is. Is it tomorrow?
The next game, I think, is tomorrow. You're right.
Oh.
And the Warriors dynasty could be over after that.
That's right.
What do you think about that?
They won the last two, right?
I think they lost one. Hold on. One of the years they lost to the Cavs. I'm not sure about the year. I'll look it up. But keep talking.
Okay, well, I think they won the last two, and then the year before that...
Oh, yeah, they did. You're right. Look how smart he is.
That's right. They won three out of the last four.
Uh-huh.
Do I think they can...
Do you think their dynasty will be tarnished if they lose 4-1 in this series?
That wouldn't be good, considering me, with my limited knowledge, like, I know they're one of the best teams. The Raptors I don't hear that much about normally. But to me, it seems like the Warriors are always in the finals, at least as long as I can remember. So yeah, I think it would be pretty surprising. When's the last time the Raptors won? Do you know?
They never won a finals.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you rooting for them?
Well, that was going to be my next talk about my next question, so let's finish this one.
Okay.
Will their dynasty be tarnished?
I don't think it could ever be, like, erased or, you know, permanently discarded. But I think that would be pretty surprising.
Mm-hmm.
And if I think it's surprising, then I can only imagine what real sports fans would think.
Wow. That's some great knowledge that you just gave everyone.
Thank you.
So, what I was going to say was, Stephen A. Smith, you know him?
I do know him.
He said in one of his last episodes of First Take, I think, that if the Warriors lose, Kevin Durant is probably going to stay in Golden State. What do you think about that? Does that make sense? Or should he move on?
That's interesting, because when you were saying that statement, I thought you were going to say, if they lose, he's going to leave.
That's what I was thinking, too.
Yeah. Are there talks of him leaving if they win?
Well, I mean, Stephen A. Smith said that if they win, he's going to leave. But if they lose, he's going to stay.
That's interesting, because I would think it would be the other way around. Opposite.
That's what I'm thinking, too. And that's why it's a question. Does that make is there any thought to that would make sense to you?
I guess if I had to rationalize it,
rationalize it.
Yeah, I guess I would say if they lose, he'd want to be like, oh, I want to stay to win another one, just to say that I won. How many has he been there for?
He's won one championship.
Oh, only one? With mm-hmm. them? Okay.
Then what is it, two?
I guess he might want to see if he could stick around for a second one. But, and then it's...
Oh, I think it's two.
Okay, so yeah, three. I like three. He'd be like, oh, I want to get three. In a row, probably.
Three in a row, but what if he loses?
If he loses,
then he loses that streak.
I could see him being like, oh, okay, I'm done with the team, I want to go to another one. Or I guess if we're doing what Mr. Smith said, that he'd want to stay to get three, although not consecutively.
Because what I'm thinking is, tell me what you think about this, because you know a lot about this. Kevin Durant, his big thing is like his ego and his legacy after he retires from basketball, and the reason he went to the Warriors was because he wasn't winning any championships when he was on the Thunder. So he went to the Warriors, and everyone saw him as like, basically, they called him like a snake or a cupcake because he went to such a team that would make it so easy for him to win a championship because they already had such good players on the team. And if they have all these players and they lose, one time is even bad, but if they lose a second time in a row, his legacy would be like totally destroyed because how can you not even win a championship when you're on such a good team? You know what I'm saying?
How many years has he been on the team?
This will be his third. So he has won two, but with what the team that the Warriors have, they should just like be able to win easily. But if they lose this one, why wouldn't he just want to leave and possibly start his own franchise, such as in New York, and build them to a championship-caliber team and gain all of his legacy back? You know what I'm saying?
So you think that even if he won this third one,
I think win or lose, he should just leave. But saying that if he... What did Stephen A. says, Matt? If he loses, then he's going to stay makes even less sense.
Okay. Because of what you just said.
Yeah.
You think it makes less sense? That's interesting. Huh. I mean, it's definitely more impressive to, you know, keep moving and not stay in the same team.
Especially with what Kevin Durant did.
Yeah, or for any player.
No, what Kevin Durant did.
With him specifically?
I'm just being stupid. Keep going.
Yeah, like I was saying before, I was really interrupted. Like, it's more impressive to, you know, keep moving and win on different teams. But, that's not to say it's not impressive to win, you know, three.
But for Kevin Durant, it's not really impressive because of the team he has around him.
Yes. I guess for, like, a different player, maybe?
Like the Steph Currys of the world, the Klay Thompsons of the world, the DeMarcus Cousins of the world that are all on one team. That's a little too much. So I really don't feel like winning more championship with them is going to really add to his legacy, is what I'm trying to say.
Do you think he would benefit more from moving?
Yes.
Do you want to tell him that?
Tell who that?
Kevin Durant?
Yeah, I'll write a letter to him.
You should do that.
Yeah.
You mentioned that you run a podcast.
You think you should be on the podcast?
No, well, that too. I'm going to say mention that you run a very influential sports podcast.
I mean, we do get like 20 listeners. I mean, that's 20 people that have the same opinion as I do, so.
I don't even know 20 people, like, in the world. That's pretty crazy.
I mean, a classroom of students is, like, 20 people, so basically I run a classroom.
It's basically like you're a professor.
Well, it depends what college you go to.
Like, let's say NYU, for example.
NYU, that's a lot of kids in one class.
Okay.
But, like...
You'll work.
I'll work on it. I mean, with this podcast, it's going to go even greater than the other ones, so...
Sky's the limit, right?
Yeah. Okay, let's continue. What's your opinion on Kawhi Leonard?
Okay. Here's the deal.
Let's hear.
I know he used to be on the... Okay. I gotta get her on the... The Spurs.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay. Because I saw him play against the Knicks once at the Garden. That's how I remember. I know something happened. Like, you... This is like a very, you know, vague description. But I know something happened. He switched teams and people were mad at him.
Do you want me to tell you what happened?
That's kind of recent. Yes, remind me.
So he was on the Spurs, and he was, like, their main star on the Spurs. The Spurs had a lot of stars, but he was their best player. And he had this foot injury that kind of wasn't supposed to be so severe. But because the Spurs training staff didn't really keep Kawhi Leonard, like, in the loop about what was actually going on, it ended up being that he was out for the whole year. And so that made him really mad. And basically, there was a point that he could have came back that year, but decided to just sit out because he's just mad at the whole Spurs organization. And that led him to being traded because he didn't want to play for the Spurs anymore.
Wow.
I know, isn't that nuts? It's nuts, right?
That is pretty crazy.
No, it's nuts.
How many... yeah, fine, it's pretty nuts. So he, like, voluntarily sat out for games?
Well, once he was actually healed. I'm pretty sure is the story.
And they, like, allow that? They let them just sit out?
There's nothing they could really do.
They can't, like, fire him, I guess.
Yeah, because he's on a contract, which is why they ended up trading him, because he said he wouldn't play for them.
So where is he now?
Oh, he's on the Raptors.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I knew that, because at school, in May... They were playing. Remember the game? He got, like, the shot at the very end.
Yeah, against the Sixers.
I think so. Okay, because I saw that, and that was pretty crazy.
Wow, you were watching live.
I was actually.
That's crazy.
That's nuts.
That's nuts. Yeah.
So,
what's your opinion of him?
I mean, he's one of the few players like I know. Not a few players, but, like, he's, I saw him on the Spurs, and now I guess I watched him on TV on the Raptors. So, I guess it's a generally positive opinion. I guess
that's a lot of info right there.
What?
That's a lot of info for our listeners right there.
That's right. I guess it's kind of strange he just, like, sat out, like, protested it, I guess.
But how do you feel about him in the finals so far?
I have absolutely no idea.
It's the first wrong answer that he's gotten so far.
I have not seen any of the games.
You're supposed to try and BS this.
What?
You're supposed to try and BS this.
I was just being honest.
But right, BSing is not being honest.
I'll BS it. Here we go. In the finals, I think he's doing well, but you know, not as well as he could. I think we see better from him in the past, and
really.
Really? Is that what you said?
Yeah.
Maybe.
You gotta pick one way.
I gotta what?
You gotta pick one way.
Fine. I think he's doing, you know what? How about this? I think he's doing fantastic.
Why is he doing fantastic? What has been his main attribute that he's added?
He's made every shot he's taken in every game of the final.
That's not true.
Well, to me it is.
Do you think he's more impactful on the offensive side or the defensive side?
Okay, I'm going to base this off of the shot that we were talking about.
The one shot?
Sixers game, and I'm going to say he's more impactful on the offensive.
But what about, like, do you feel like he does anything on the defensive side?
I mean, yeah, no player does nothing, really, on the defensive. I guess they just didn't put effort, and they just stood there.
Yeah.
But, you know, certain players have different strengths, and I think he's in the offense.
But do you think he puts effort onto the defensive side of the basketball game?
You have to put some, unless you're, I guess, really experienced and you're tired of doing it.
Mm-hmm. So you think his main attribute is offensive? What do I think? I think he's known as one of the best two-way players in basketball, which means he's great on the offense and defensive side of the ball. I think you're right. You think so, too? Yeah. That's not what you said. That's a little weird, but okay. So I think that on paper and in the stat sheets, it seems like his offense is what makes him who he is, but I feel like his defense is what got him through the series against the Bucks, because one of the main things that Nick Nurse, you know Nick Nurse?
No, I do not.
You're supposed to BS it and say you do?
Yes, I do know Nick Nurse.
You know Nick Nurse. And one of Nick Nurse was known for in that series was changing up his defensive scheme, right?
Right, right.
Where he put Kawhi Leonard on Giannis Antetokounmpo.
I know that name.
No, you don't. And basically made Giannis less of an impactful player for the Bucks, which led the Raptors to come back in that series. You know what I'm talking about?
I'm sorry, did you say something?
You didn't hear? Okay, whatever, the listeners.
No, I'm kidding. yes, I agree with the points you made about Nick Nurse and Giannis and the Bucks.
Yeah?
I agree with all that,
yeah. One of our previous conversations that I've had with the other podcasters is talking about who they think the MVP of this season has been.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to give you three names, and I need you to give reasons for each of them.
Interesting. Okay.
James Harden, Giannis, and Kawhi Leonard. Start with Giannis. Who's the second? James Harden.
No, here's the first.
Giannis. Oh.
Like.
Oh, okay.
Giannis?
Giannis, James Harden, and Kawhi Leonard.
Hang on, you're breaking up.
Giannis.
Okay, James Harden.
And Kawhi Leonard.
Gotcha. All right. So reasons they could be the MVP.
Yeah.
All right, James Harden, correct me if I'm wrong, he's on the Rockets.
Yeah.
And the thing I know about him is that he's a cool beard.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that that's pretty MVP worthy.
Really? You think that holds him over the Greek Freak?
What'd you call me?
The Greek Freak. I'm not talking about you.
Who's that, Giannis?
Yeah.
I don't know what he looks like. But he can't have a beard like that.
So you're just holding the physical appearance?
I don't know what team he's on.
But you're holding the physical appearance over the NBA quality of a player.
Yes, because that is all I know.
But you're supposed to BS it.
You said that. You keep saying, fine. What team is Giannis on?
You're supposed to know that.
Okay, I don't.
The Bucks. I already talked about him.
Okay, fine. I'll BS it. James Harden. He's the best player on the Rockets.
Yeah.
So that's why he should be MVP. Although.
What you're saying is, this is another debate. Is it about the, if he's, okay, the MVP, most valuable player, should it be based off... We'll get back to the other question. Should it be based off...
After?
Yeah, we can. Should it be based off how good the whole team is? So, like... how do I explain this? Should it be based off how good the whole team is or how the stats of the individual player? So, like, if the MVP is on a bad team, if a player that has MVP power... Do you know what I'm saying?
I kind of.
Okay. So, like, if there's a really good player, but he's on a bad team, and the team does not do well that season, does that take him out of the MVP race because the team is bad, or is he still in it because he's really good?
Well, let me ask this before I answer that. Is the MVP usually on one of the two final teams?
It doesn't have to be. And it's not usually. Recently, yes, because the two finals teams have just been... The players on them have been really good, but... It's not usually.
I mean, it's not, I guess, the players' fault entirely if the whole team is not great.
Uh-huh.
If, like... If the player is exceptional and the rest of the team isn't, and even if they don't make it, you know, far, if they think he's the best player, then I guess I don't see a reason why he could be the MVP.
I can see what you're saying there.
Do you think it's a...
Always go back and forth with this, because if you think about, like, the definition of most valuable player in the NBA, it should just be based off stats. But if you're the most valuable player, why does your team suck? Because you should be able to, as the most valuable player, take your team from being really bad to being really good.
Gotcha.
But in the modern era of basketball, where it's super teams, I can see why it's hard to make the MVP race based off how good your team is. What's your thoughts?
Can you repeat the last sentence?
No. Okay, we'll just go back to the last question.
okay, I hadn't thought of it that way when you said if they're the most valuable player as opposed to the best player, then why isn't their team in the finals?
That posed an interesting question, eh?
And you know what? It might be one of life's unanswered questions.
That's true.
Okay. Such as who built the pyramids and where does...
Right, if aliens are real.
That too.
What's the meaning of life?
Well, that's not on it. Yes. Well, kind of.
All right. I don't think that's answered, but okay. all right, we'll get back to the last question. We need reasons for why James Harden, Giannis, and Kawhi Leonard should be MVPs. And finally, who you think the MVP should be. And then we'll end it there.
Alright, I gave my reasons for James Harden, right?
Can you repeat them again?
I don't think I can.
Okay.
But, it was something about... Wait, 1 second, yes? That one sec.
Evan is currently talking.
1 second, people.
I'll give some background noise. I'm not going to cut this out. This is staying
on. Wait, why don't you cut this and tell them I had a side conversation?
Because it's good, interesting content.
If that's the case, what are your thoughts on doing that background noise we referred to? 20 more seconds.
Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Alright, I don't need to have background noise. I can just talk. I think Evan is currently in his room. I'm gonna look around his room because his phone's down and he's talking to someone else. In the top left-hand corner, I see what looks like an air conditioning vent. There's some stars and moon on the ceiling, kind of like outer space. And then on the wall, there are some records because he's a big music and Broadway guy. So he's very interested in that stuff. I don't know how much more I can BS, but I'll try. I think he's either talking to his mother or his brother. You know, podcasting can be hard because anyone can interrupt you at any time, and you just have to stay on your feet. That's what we try to do here at the Sport Universe. We try to stay on our feet. I hope you've been watching our highlight videos that we've been putting up on the YouTube channel. I just did a Kyrie Irving YouTube video. That one was kind of hard to make because there's a lot of Kyrie Irving content.
Alright, I'm back.
Oh, he's back.
What were you describing?
Just your room.
That's what I thought.
And what I could see.
What did you see?
I saw an air vent, some stars and moons, and a record on your wall.
Over there.
So, who are you talking to?
I wasn't
even a break. Oh, right. Yeah, no, sometimes, I was telling them about the life of podcasters and how sometimes you get anxious during podcasting. You just need to take a break.
That's true.
But
it's not what I was doing. I was talking to my parents.
Okay, so now Evan's making excuses for that he wasn't anxious during the podcast. And it's okay to be anxious.
Let's just do it.
In 2019, it's okay to be anxious.
It's what?
That's what you gotta do sometimes. Take a break. Relax your mind.
You're breaking up.
Currently, we're having bad connection, so we're just gonna get through that, and then once we're back up and running, we'll continue our sports conversations. Is he here? Hello, Evan.
I think we're fine now.
There we go. Okay, so we need reasons for why Giannis should be MVP and why Kawhi Leonard should be MVP, and then I'll give you my reasons.
Giannis, because he's a long last name.
Okay.
And he sounds good.
Uh-huh. What makes him sound good? Just his name?
Yeah, it sounds like special.
It sounds like a good player?
Yeah.
Do you think that's just because they say his name a lot because he's always in highlights?
I think they say his name a lot because it sounds cool.
Oh, okay.
And Kawhi, because he's my boy. I followed him from the Spurs now to the Raptors.
You follow him on Instagram or you just follow him?
I do not. I'm devoted to him. I follow him.
You're really? Do you have like pictures on your wall of him?
That's not what I mean. I mean, I am a big fan of Kawhi.
You're a big fan.
I've tracked his career path from.
That's weird that you didn't know he was on the Raptors though.
I forgot, like I said.
Oh, okay. So who do you think should win MVP?
Out of those three?
Yeah.
I mean, I haven't been hearing anything about James Harden this season, really.
Mm-hmm.
The only name I've... Okay, yeah, so I haven't heard anything about him. I have heard of, the Greek... What do you call him? The Greek guy?
The Greek freak.
Yeah, him too. I've heard his name, but I think out of the three, it should be... because of that shot.
Just because of the shot?
No, Brian. Not solely because of that shot. But, that was definitely pretty impressive. And you know what, to be honest? I've heard his name the most this season, so I think he should get it.
So you think name recognition is big?
That's right.
Okay. Interesting. I'm gonna say what I think. So, I'm gonna give the reasons for each. James Harden, he is insane at what they call offense in basketball, and I'd say that's his main component to his game. He's not really good on the defensive side, but what he's done offensively this season is crazy. I'm going to get his stats up just so I can read them, but I think why you haven't heard his name a lot is that he was in the playoffs, but the team was not in it for long because they lost early on, so you haven't heard his name in the spotlight a lot. But here's his stats. In 2018, listen to this, Evan.
I'm listening.
It's going to be insane. He averaged 36 points, 6.6 rebounds, and 7.5 assists.
How do you get point rebounds?
What was it? Oh, how do you get point rebounds? That's the average.
Oh, like how many, like you made them?
Yeah. No, rebounds.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So from that, he's not only a scorer, but he passes the ball, he rebounds. He's just been so good offensively for so many years that this year especially he deserves the MVP, or should be one of the candidates. Giannis, he's another player like Kawhi who's good offensively and defensively. I still feel like... hold on. Did this stop recording? Hello? Okay, it didn't stop recording.
Good.
So, who is that time? Giannis. He's good offensively and defensively. He's been definitely, from the beginning of his career to now, one of those players that just transforms himself, which is very rare and something that's very nice to see in a sport that usually you just have the skills and that's what you play with, but he's been able to transform his basketball game, which is very big for him. But personally, I agree with Evan that Kawhi Leonard, especially if they win the finals, should win the MVP, because he's, not only was he really good during the regular season, he's been even better during the playoffs and has taken a Raptors team that's never made it to the finals and has had a history of doing really bad in the playoffs to the finals and possibly being the greatest team ever, which makes him what I think to be an MVP.
Basically, you just took my answer and paid
it. Yeah?
Yeah.
I said exactly what you said. All right.
Well, it must have been a very educated answer, I guess.
I think we have reached 30 minutes, which is what we wanted this podcast to be, or at least I wanted. So I think we're going to say goodbye for now. Evan, you have any final words?
I'm honored that Brian allowed me to do this, you know?
I mean, Evan basically begged me, so.
That is just inaccurate. When I asked him if we were doing it, he said, sure, what time? I thought he was going to say, no, you don't know anything. But,
you gotta give opportunities to everyone.
Basically, that means he's using my lack of knowledge to make a fool of me and increase the views.
Hey guys, we had a little system overload because of all... It overheated because of the fire content we produce every day here at the Sportuniverse. So, I think where we left off, we were just saying goodbye. I told Evan that I could just end it, but he wanted to fix what he said. So, Evan, you have some final words you want to say?
Yeah, so some of this might be, you know, repeat, depends on what the last part picked up, but, I want to thank Brian for, indulging me.
You said that already.
I know.
Oh, you're just saying it again because you're such a nice guy.
Well, that too. Mm-hmm. Right. Brian basically begged me to be on the podcast because he said the viewership was going down and he needed some humor to bring it back up.
I didn't say that. I'm pretty sure, I don't know where it ended, but I said that Evan was begging me to be on it because he was jealous.
That part's not true either.
My success.
I asked him once. I asked him on Friday, can we do a podcast? He said, sure.
No. He asked me on Friday, and I was indifferent about it, and then he texted me and said, are we doing a podcast tomorrow? And I was like, sure.
Yeah, and I was really surprised because I didn't think he'd want me to. But I guess he was a little out of it that day, so he said yes. Now we're getting...
Yeah, I guess I was out of it.
but yeah, like I said, new podcast every afternoon, me and Brian, starting July 1st.
Yeah, our camp season starts, we're just going to hold a phone against our faces and just talk. And that's our podcast every day.
The entire camp day, we're going to be mic'd up.
Yeah.
We're going to talk sports.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, thanks to our sponsor, like I was saying.
Yeah, our sponsor being who?
Oh, you're asking me?
Yeah.
Our sponsor, well, I can't say any real names because I think they can sue us for claiming to sponsor us.
Oh, right. Yeah, that's true. Good point.
But how about this? I'll say we're sponsored by a certain salad restaurant and a certain drink company and a certain summer camp.
Yeah.
Yeah. So thank you.
So those are Evan's final words that he wanted to redo because he obviously messed up in the first time, but you guys don't know what he said. Or you do. I don't really know where the last recording ended, but I'll finish it off. I don't know if we'll be back next week with Evan. We'll definitely be back with the regular co-host that know things about sports.
Wait.
What?
I don't know.
Okay. Maybe if this does good, we can make it a weekly thing. Or however much we want to do it. Check
I
out...
I
don't think they heard what you said, but that doesn't matter.
I guarantee it will do.
And so check out our YouTube videos that I put up. Highlight videos Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and on the weekends we do podcasts. I just did a Kyrie Irving video. That took me a while to do, so check that out. It's the Sport Universe on YouTube. If you're also go read our articles on thesportuniverse.com.